Next topic is the ELISA, enzyme linked immunosorbate assay. So what the requirements here is micro titer plate, purified antigen antibodies, buffer, enzymes and spectrophotometer. These are the requirements for this ELISA test. ELISA is divided into two types, direct ELISA, indirect ELISA. Direct ELISA is used for detection of antigen. Indirect ELISA is used for detection of the antibody. So in direct ELISA, there are two types of ELISAs are present, sandwich type and competitive set type. So in sandwich type, generally they are used to detect the multivalent antigen or antigen is binded to the antibody correctly or not. So here antigen present between two antibodies. Antigen is present between the two antibody layers, sandwich, that's why we are calling here. Primary antibody means antibody which is binded to the antigen. Primary means antibody binded to the antigen. Secondary means antibody which is binded to the primary antibody. It is a binded to the primary antibody. Primary binded to the antigen. Primary binded to the antigen. Secondary is binded to the primary antibody. So these are difference between the primary and secondary antibody. In sandwich type, first they are treated with the primary antibody and antigen. Again primary antibody, because sandwich formation is required. If antibody is binded, secondary antibody with enzyme will be binded and substrate is added, color will be produced. Color is producing positive, that means antibody is binded to, suited to the antigen. If it is negative, here antibody is not binded to the antigen, secondary antibody will not be binded, color is not produced. So color produced positive, color not produced negative. That means antibody is not suited for the antigen. Next method is the competitive method. So here competition between the purified HCG and enzyme and test HCG, pregnant woman blood or urine. So first they are adding test HCG. If HCG and human chorionogonadotropic hormone, which is present only pregnant woman blood and urine, it is released by the placenta. So if it is present, it is binded to the antibodies. Next, purified HCG with enzyme is added, it is not binded because already it is occupied by the test HCG. So if it is not binded, substrate is added, no color is produced. That means pregnancy is negative. Pregnancy test is negative. If color is not produced, that means here pregnancy is positive. Pregnancy is positive. So that means here, inside the urine and blood HCG is present. That's why whatever purified HCG with enzyme is added, that is not binded. Here competition between this purified HCG with enzyme and true HCG present in urine and blood. So if urine and blood is added, if HCG is present, it is occupied the antibody. Purified HCG with enzyme is not binded. Substrate is added, no color is produced. That's why it is the positive for the pregnancy. In second case, she is not pregnant. So HCG is not present. That's why here purified HCG with enzyme is binded, color is produced. So here color is produced, antibody antigen reaction is positive. Here color is produced negative, oppositely present in competition and sandwich method. Now come to the indirect ELISA, which is used for detection of antibodies. In first step, they are coated with the antigen. Known HIV antigens will be coated. Later, who is suspected, that person's serum is added. If positive antibodies are present, HIV antibodies are present. If it is negative, HIV antibodies are absent. So positive case, it is binded. Negative case, it is not binded. Next, if it is binded primary antibody, that means HIV antibody is binded. Then secondary antibody with enzyme is added along with the substrate. So if primary antibody HIV antibody is present, this is binded, substrate is there, color is produced. If negative, no antibody is binded, color will not be founded. Color is formed, positive. Color is not formed, that is the negative.